A man walks into the Basque village of Artigues, high in the French Pyrenees, and is readily accepted by his family. However, this man is not who he says he is, and is in fact an imposter. Martin de Guerre was born near 1524 in the village of Hende. 3 years later, his family moved to the village of Artigues, and his family changed their last names to Guerre. When Martin was 14, he was married to 11-year-old Bertrand de Rolls. For 8 years, the marriage was without children until the birth of a son. However, in 1548, Martin was accused of stealing grain from his father and was forced to flee his home. The laws of the time did not allow his wife to remarry. 8 years later, in 1556, a man arrived in Artigues claiming to be Martin Guerre. Due to similar appearance and a detailed knowledge of Guerre, this man was able to convince most of the villagers, including Guerre's uncle and four sisters, alongside his wife. The man lived for 3 years with Bertrand and her son, and the couple had two children together, with only one daughter surviving. However, Martin's uncle, Pierre Guerre, who had married Bertrand's widowed mother, had become suspicious of the man claiming to be Martin when the man sued Pierre for the inheritance of Martin's father, who had died during Martin's absence. Pierre and his wife tried to convince Bertrand that her husband was an imposter. Along with this, a soldier passed through Artigues claiming to know Martin. And the soldier stated that the man was a fraud, pointing out that the real Martin Guerre had lost a leg during a war. Due to this, Pierre and his son-in-laws attacked the imposter with clubs, but Bertrand intervened. In 1559, many villagers, alongside Pierre Guerre, accused the man claiming to be Martin of arson and of impersonating the real Martin Guerre, with Bertrand remaining on the imposter's side. And the imposter was acquitted in early 1560. However, Pierre had been investigating in the meantime and had come up with a theory about the true identity of the man claiming to be his nephew. Arnaud Dutil, nicknamed Pansette, a con artist from the village of Til in the Sahas region. Pierre brought a new case against the imposter, claiming to act in Bertrand's name, as the wronged wife could bring the suit back. Pierre and his wife, Bertrand's mother, pressured Bertrand to support the charges, to which she eventually complied. In mid-1560, the trial was held in Rieux. Bertrand testified that at first she honestly believed the man was her husband, but had since realized his imposture. However, both Bertrand and the imposter were able to reiterate personal stories from before 1548. The man claiming to be Martin then challenged Bertrand, stating that if she swore he was not her husband, he would agree to be executed. But she could not do that. After hearing from over 150 witnesses, the accused was convicted and sentenced to death by beheading. However, Dutil would not take this lying down and immediately appealed to the Parliament of Toulouse. Officials arrested Pierre and Bertrand on charges of false accusation and soliciting perjury in Pierre's case. Dutil argued his case in a manner that caused the judges in Toulouse to believe his narrative that the greedy Pierre Guerre had pressured Bertrand to commit perjury. The imposter even had to undergo detailed questioning about Martin's past, with no contradictions found. But then the unexpected happened. During the trial, a man appeared in Toulouse with a wooden leg, claiming to be the true Martin Guerre. Despite forgetting some details about his past, when the two men were presented to the Guerre family, the case was closed, Pierre, Bertrand, and his four sisters all concluded that the newly arrived man was the true Martin Guerre. Arnaud Dutille maintained his innocence, but was convicted of adultery and fraud and sentenced to death. This was when Arnaud confessed. Dutille stated that he had learned of Martin's life after two men confused him with Guerre. He then decided to take Guerre's place, with two conspirators helping him with the details. Arnaud Dutille apologized to all involved, including Bertrand, for his deception. He was hanged in front of Martin's house in Artigat 4 days later. However, there is still one unanswered question. What exactly did Martin Guerre do in his absence? Initially, Martin Guerre moved to Spain, where he started off in a local militia, but later joined the Spanish army, being sent to Flanders and losing his leg in the 1557 attack on St. Quentin. For years after this, Guerre lived in a monastery before finally deciding to return home in 1560. However, his reason for returning is still unknown. The story of Martin Guerre and the imposter who tried to steal his life has inspired many accounts of the tale. With the History Admirable by Guillaume Lesueur and the Arrest Memorable by one of the judges who resided over the case, Jean de Carras, both being written in the immediate aftermath. And the more contemporary Return of Martin Guerre being published by Princeton history professor Natalie Davis. Alongside this nonfiction accounts, various fictional accounts of the tale also exist, with even a movie being adapted in 1982 alongside various musicals and plays.